Welcome to the Austin Beat. I'm Holly Mills-Gardner. We have a great show for you today. We're going to take you to the premiere of Sin City 2, A Dame to Kill For, and talk with director Robert Rodriguez himself. We're going to sit down with Colin Kendrick of Black Fret and give you the first of the two-part interview with Bobby Epstein of Circuit of the Americas. This is the Austin Beat.
Here we are, pal. All of a sudden, this doesn't look like the brightest idea you ever had.
You have 10 seconds to tell us what you're doing bringing cops to Old Town.
Hey, I'm downtown tonight at the Paramount Theater here in Austin for the premiere of Frank Miller's Sin City, A Dame to Kill For. It's co-directed by Austin's own Robert Rodriguez. I am with the one and only Robert Rodriguez, director, creator, writer, producer. Lots of credits for you tonight.
Oh my gosh, I didn't think about it until you just said them all. I'm tired just hearing it. This is, you know what, I love having a lot of fun. And here in Austin, we can do it in a different way than anybody else. Everybody on my crew does multiple jobs because it's a very much like a family affair and doing whatever it takes to get it done. But I really just love those jobs. You know, getting him doing the score, and then I think, wow, wouldn't it be cool to have Steven Tyler sing this? Let me send it to him. Oh, yeah, he's down. Let's go get it. You know, we had the LA premiere, which was fantastic. All the actors were there. It was a big to-do. But there's nothing like the Austin crowd. I mean, this is their film. We made it here. So the energy and the excitement you get from an Austin screening is unlike any other one.
We just left the premiere of Sin City 2 at the Paramount. We've made our way over to the Rattle Inn here in Austin for the one and only after party.
Play a clean tone like most saxophone players play. And now do the Johnny Texas sound. It reeks, it's so nasty. So we started off Grindhouse with, and we go.
This is Holly Mills-Gardner. You're watching the Austin Beat. We'll be right back after this message.
Buffington Homes builds gorgeous homes in Central Texas's most sought-after communities. Buffington Homes is now building in High Point. This gated Austin community is in the highly acclaimed Dripping Springs School District, featuring resort-style amenities and rolling hill country views. At High Point, you'll enjoy a two-story workout facility, tennis courts, multiple pools, ponds, and miles of hike and bike trails throughout the heavily wooded community. Visit mybuffington.com and build your dream home in High Point with Austin's leading locally owned builder, Buffington Homes.
Do not pay another energy bill before calling 1-800-SOLAR-USA. Austin's fastest growing solar company is looking for 20 homes to eliminate their energy bill and get paid to display new state-of-the-art solar panels. Call 1-800-SOLAR-USA.
Welcome back to the Austin Beat. I am Holly, of course, and I am here with my great friend, Linda Asaf, at her new store called Design Lab, which, by the way, is amazing. I'm so excited for you.
Thank you so much.
Tell our viewers actually about how this all came about, because what's really cool is you have so many designers, not just yourself, but so many that are actually featured here. It's really cool.
Thank you. Well, I definitely have a passion for supporting other local designers and helping the fashion industry grow here in Austin. So the opportunity came to me and I was so excited. And I, after doing years of research on hunting out the best designers in Texas, I was surprised to see how many incredibly talented people are here doing and creating and having viable businesses.
Yeah, there is definitely creativity all in this place. And as most of you in Austin know, Linda, she is a fashion designer and a very good one at that. I'm actually wearing one of her pieces. She dresses me quite often, and I will say what's coming up is Formula One. And so I had to sport something that would be so perfect for Formula One. So tell me, what do you think? Because I hope that most people watching are going to be attending Formula One. And if they are, what would you suggest that they wear?
Well, there's two different things you need to be aware of. There's the daytime at the track and then all the nightlife. Mm-hmm. And they're two separate things in terms of what you want to wear, because when you're at the track, you need to walk long distances, even if you have premium parking in the front of the track. So mm-hmm. I recommend going stylish, but also very comfortable for day. And then for night, I think anything goes.
I agree. Nighttime turns more party-ish. Mm-hmm. So daytime at track, I agree on that. So you're on your feet quite often at Formula One. And people are always asking me, what do I wear? What do I wear to the track? Do I wear a dress? Is it that dressy? And it's still Austin. And I try to remind people that. So it's really important, I would say, to be very chic. Yes. And very race appropriate, and then change for the nighttime parties. Show me something that you have in the store that would be appropriate to wear to the track.
To the track.
Yes.
Okay. Well, we have this great piece here. I call it the Infinity Vest. Should I put it on?
Put it on, because this is so cool, by the way. I love this, and I may steal it. So if you don't get out here first to try this on, love the piece.
Perfect. It's got the perfect amount of attitude and style, and it's easy, and it'll keep you warm when you're sitting there watching the race. And it's just a loop, but it's super fun. It's Persian lan, and that's it.
How cool is that? Look at the back.
The back, so you can wear it with jeans, or you can wear it out at night. The collar comes off, and you can wear it just with the suede.
Who is the designer on this?
Oh, me.
Of course. Of course. I love it. I love it. So cool. And then, of course, you could make that into night as well. But there Absolutely. Are some amazing pieces that I see over here that would go into some of the parties. Of course, one of the biggest parties that's going on for Formula One is the fashion show itself, which is Full Tilt, which yes. Linda produces. And I get to host again this year, so I'm so excited. I want everybody to show up for the fashion show. There's going to be tons of these designers that are featured,
yes.
right?
Yes. Design Lab is sponsoring about 9 designers from the store who are all going to be part of the show. But we're also featuring Byron Lars, who has magnificent clothing, mm-hmm. and also Fleur de Nuit lingerie. So there'll be lingerie and my swimwear, and then also Lore Brazilian fashion.
Very, very cool. So I see some party dresses too back here, which sure. is so fun because outside of the fashion show, it leads into some great parties we're going to talk about later, like Blue at the W and things like that. So this is something that, this looks very familiar to me. That's a local designer, isn't it?
Yes, it's Daniel Esquivel, and it is a fabulous, I call it like a bat wing dress because it's a really chic silk lurex shift dress, but on the back, it's attached from the shoulders and reattaches down at the hem. So it's a really dramatic look that anybody can wear. And then you can add jewelry and really make it cool.
Yeah, that is very cool. There is so much here at Design Lab. I want you to come out and check it out if you haven't already. It's out at the Oasis. It's beautiful. And it's featuring, I bet, 20 plus different Texas designers, and
every 30 plus.
Yes. Correct me on that. I love it. 30 plus, everything from jewelry to eyewear, mm-hmm. cowboy boots to game day wear yes. to Formula One wear. There is exactly. so much here. So I want you to come and check it out. And then of course, also you can see Linda and so many of these designers being featured at the Full Tilt fashion show, which is during Formula One. Tell us the date on that, the time, and where we can get tickets to show.
Okay. It's Saturday, November 1st. 6 o'clock is the cocktail hour. 7 o'clock is the show. And we have an after party in a pop-up shop, which is new this year. It'll be really fun. And it's at the W Hotel downtown. And to get tickets, you go to fulltiltaustin.com.
Okay, did you hear that? Go to fulltiltaustin.com. Get your tickets. I'm hosting the show, and it's amazing. I think I've done it. This will be my 3rd year to host the show, and it's such a cool event. And then, of course, it leads into a huge party afterwards, which, you know, everybody from the track comes to and all the celebrities, and mm-hmm. it's a blast. But this show will feature tons of designers, amazing pieces. I want you to check this out. You have done such a great job.
Thank you.
And many know this is a trailblazer in the business of fashion in Austin. So for her to collaborate with other designers just speaks volumes. So congratulations.
Thank you so much.
You are so welcome. All right, stay tuned. We're going to give you more right here on the Austin Beat.
What can you do in 31 days? How about moving to your own home? Buffington Homes has over 60 new homes ready to move into in as little as 31 days. Choose from one stories, two stories, large or small, north or south. Buffington Homes builds in the most desired communities in the Austin area, so you're sure to find one that fits your needs. Whether giving you more space for your kids or your favorite collection, having a place to barbecue outdoors or plant a garden, Buffington Homes has a solution. Find your move-in ready home today at mybuffington.com.
Welcome Welcome back to the Austin Beat. I am here at the Paramount Theater in Austin, of course, with Colin Kendrick. Hi, Colin.
Hi.
Colin is actually the founder of, I'm going to let you tell me about two different foundations that you've started.
So I started along with some other people, myself and Nikki Rowling and Matt Ott, started the Austin Music Foundation about 12 years ago. It's an organization that provides business mentoring and education to local artists. It's founded around the concept of teach a man to fish. We're trying to take Austin's musicians and find them a path to create a sustainable living as an artist.
And that's hard to do in this city, and therefore it's really changed some lives of artists. Is that correct?
It has, yeah. We serve 2,000 to 3,000 musicians a year through the Austin Music Foundation. Black Fred is an evolution of a program we ran within the Austin Music Foundation called the Austin Music Incubator. Black Fred is a spin-out from the Austin Music Foundation that is focused on providing financial assistance and mentoring at the very highest level to Austin's cream of the crop in the music circles.
And that, of course, is the new organization that we are talking about today. So from the Austin Music Foundation, you had a model that you really wanted to create, and that is now Black Fret, which, of course, I know all of our viewers are wondering, like I am, what does Black Fret mean?
The concept of the name Black Fret came from the concept of a fret, the metal piece of metal on a guitar, right?
Right.
A pillar against which music gets made, right? And so the concept was we wanted to build something, you know, firm and stable against which music could be made. The concept of black, you know, we were joking around about Spinal Tap and how much more black can it be? And then there you go, Black Fret. It's also indicative of a model. We're a limited membership model. And to some degree, our members are out in the community as sort of secret society members finding the best bands and bringing them back to us.
Well, let's talk about that, because I'm sure a lot of people want to know how they can get involved and be a part of Black Fret, changing the lives of musicians right here in Austin, because, of course, we have an abundance of them. I mean, everywhere you turn, live music capital of the world,
There's
a new artist or an artist trying to be discovered. So how would people get involved with this organization?
Black Fret's open to the public. Anyone can join. Visit www.blackfret.org. So the grants are financially material. They're $10,000 this year. The aspiration is for that to be closer to $25,000 to $50,000. So it's enough money. We call it transformative money. It's enough money that it can help a band do something they wouldn't be able to do on their own, quit their day job for a year,
right,
go into a high-end professional recording studio. And so the things we fund are the creation and performance of music. Bands unlock grant dollars by writing new songs, by touring, by performing for other local nonprofits.
Thank you so much, Colin. It's such a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you. All right, check this out. Lola got this for us.
Lola Lehman. I'm outside of the legendary Spider House Ballroom for Black Fret. I'm here with Johnny Gray. Tell me, what does it mean to you to be nominated for a Black Fret grant?
It's actually really cool. You know, I first found out about this for the Austin Music Awards, actually. I was one of the people that kind of jumped over the hurdles and kind of like came into the Black Fret because of I won a few Austin Music Awards. And so I got to meet Colin and Matt, and it's totally a cool thing. When he was like, hey, congratulations on your Austin Music Awards, and guess what? You're a nominee.
By the way.
And I was like, well, very nice to meet you, and thank you for making me part of this.
I love this city. Music, film, fashion, fun, philanthropy, and now the food beat with Robert Fleming from All Affair. Robert?
Hey, Robert Fleming with American Breakfast here, and one of the staples in my kitchen is red peppers. I love them because they add a certain sweetness, and when you eat them raw, they add a nice crunch to whatever you put them in, whether it's a salad, a sandwich, and just eating them by the slice can't be beat, especially when they're in season. So you're wondering now what I've got here. Well, I've got my red peppers, and I've got my roasted red peppers, and I'll get to that in a minute, and I've got my finished red peppers. But let's talk about this red pepper first. When you select them at the store, I like to get them fairly large and straight. When you end up with a lot of nooks and crannies as we go through this process, it doesn't quite get in there. So when you're looking for them to make a salsa with or to just have as a roasted pepper, take and get one that's fairly straight without a lot of nooks and crannies. Now, what we do to get to this point here is pretty simple, and you can do this at home. We're going to do this today on a gas stove, but if you don't have a gas stove, you can use your barbecue. You can use the oven with the broiler. Heck, you can even go out to the garage and get the propane torch. No, 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 not that froofy creme brulee thing they sell at all the kitchen stores. Just a regular old plumber's torch will work just fine, and you can blister up these skins. So I'm going to take one now, and let's get it on the stove. We've got our flame on. And so now we've roasted the peppers, and this is what we end up with. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to slide them into a plastic bag. What does that do? It helps to steam the skin loose so they just peel right off. And after you've peeled them, you'll split them and seed them. And then what you do is you slice them and clean them. And we've got this, which is our red pepper. And you keep this in the refrigerator. It's fabulous. You can dice it up and put it in whatever you're cooking. I like to take and put them on a sandwich with maybe a little eggplant or some capicola or some salami, and it makes a great sandwich filler as well. And if you're a vegetarian, leave the meat out and just have the roasted vegetables. They're fabulous.
This is Holly Mills-Gardner. You're watching the Austin Beat. We'll be right back after this message.
Do not pay another energy bill before calling 1-800-SOLAR-USA. You must call today, 1-800-SOLAR-USA, 1-800-SOLAR-USA. Don't pay for your energy. Have the energy company pay you. Call 1-800-SOLAR-USA.
Hi, I'm Holly Mills-Gardner, and I spend most of my time on this side of the lens. But when it comes to my camera, I trust the professionals at Precision Camera and Video, just like the pros. With a huge selection of cameras and accessories from entry-level to top-of-the-line pro video, all here under one roof. Conveniently located at 2438 West Anderson Lane and on the web at precision-camera.com, where the pros go. And when your equipment needs service, do what I do and trust the skilled technicians here at Precision Camera and Video. Welcome back to the Austin Beat. I am Holly Mills-Gardner, your host, and we are out at Circuit of the Americas today with Formula One fast approaching. You know, it was really hard for me to pick one beat when I talk about CODA. Well, I sat down for an exclusive interview with Bobby Epstein. Check this out. Welcome back to the Austin Beat. I am Holly Mills-Gardner, your host, and I am out at Circuit of the Americas. Of course, we are right around the corner from Formula One. And I had the pleasure of sitting down today with the chairman and co-founder of Circuit of the Americas, Mr. Bobby Epstein. How are you?
I'm great. Thank
you. Good. I'm so glad we're actually getting to talk again, because the last time I got to interview you was the very first year of Formula One.
Right.
It is amazing as an Austinite, number one, but then also as someone who covers it, that I have watched this grow and affect our city so much. Yeah. How much has it affected Austin?
Well, I think it's affected it in a really positive way, and many people had a lot of fears, and I don't think they realized what we were really trying to do out here. And so, just if you look at, you know, just the British Airways plane that just flew by, you know, that when they make a statement and say, you know, Formula One's one of the reasons we came to Austin, and then you find out that there's more than 10 million in tips and gratuities that get left behind, and you realize how many thousands of people get impacted, and so the origin was Formula One for a lot of these good things, but what it spawned from there is what I think we're most proud of.
I am too, because, you know, and correct me if I'm wrong, because there are so many tracks around the world that, of course, support a Formula One race, but this is a multi-use track. And I'm not sure that all of them, in fact, any of them, do that like we do. So
Right. Everything
from concerts to other sports to X Games now to you name it. Tell me how that's all come about.
Well, from the very beginning, it was meant to be more than F1, but F1 was clearly the gem and the launching that ignited everything else that happened. But from the very beginning, the vision was to make this just an entertainment destination, a place that people look forward to coming to, because whatever happens here, they're going to have a nice time, and they're going to create memories. They're going to come with friends and family, and so it's a multi-purpose place. Mm-hmm. A racetrack is part of it. And you talk about the amphitheater that, you know, won the Polestar best new venue in the world.
That's right. I read that.
Yeah.
So the track also won the best track for F1 in 2012. Is that correct?
It did. And it won the best sporting event in the U.S.
Which is amazing.
Over some really good other, there were a lot of big sporting events every year. So
that's
it was
right.
Great. But that happens not just because of a nice facility, but it really happened because of the fans and because Austin embraced it. It really makes the event more than just a single sporting experience.
Right.
And that's why it gets that recognition.
Well, and for Formula One, if you don't know, when you are out here, and you've got to check this out, because over, 115,000 people filled the stands last year just to watch the race. So that's not saying how many came to our city.
Yes. Neiman Marcus will tell you that their registers were working during Formula One.
I would. So. I'm not to blame. Well, kind of. A little bit.
No, you know, it's true. There is. There were 250,000 people that came out to the track over the weekend. But you know that the family that comes to town is larger than that who just comes out to Dakota. And you know, it's a weekend festival, which a lot of people don't realize. I think Austin's still learning a little bit about what this is about. You know, there's an hour and 40-minute F1 race on Sunday, but it's really about the whole weekend of activities. And so people will come and go during the weekend. Some people come, you know, for a couple hours Saturday and all day Sunday or you know, whatever fits their schedule.
Yes, and speaking of schedule, there's actually so much going on that it's now trickled into, I would say, a week or two and not just a weekend now, because so many people in this community have started to jump on the festivities of Formula One and some of the other races that go on here and some of the other activities that go on here, but now fashion shows and philanthropic efforts from different organizations have really pushed around the city, and then parties. The parties are unbelievable. So I know we went to
a few. You probably know more than I do.
I have to cover them, darn, huh?
Yeah.
But we did. So the first year was amazing. We had some amazing VIP parties going on, and a lot of people come in that follow the circuit of Formula One, and it's all over the world. So they'll be in Abu Dhabi, and they'll go to these different places and take their parties to each place. So they actually bring them to Austin, Texas, which is kind of cool for
us.
And it seems to be a little bit more, seems like the lifestyle of the rich and famous, but I don't want to send that message to Austin, and you don't either, right?
No, you don't. We definitely don't. And that's been one of the great misconceptions that we see trending the opposite way as people start to experience it and realize 60,000 people come out just as a general admission ticket. It costs $139 to buy a ticket to get to see all of Sunday, and you're getting the race, you're getting the festival, you get all the exhibits, and you get Kid Rock this year.
Yes.
All is part of that, and I think it's about wandering and exploring. There's 3 miles of things to do, whether that's you've got a Bavarian beer garden where the girls are dressed in character.
Yes.
There's a cantina in one area. There's a big sports bar. And this year's theme is How the West Was Formula One.
Uh-huh. Got
it. And so there are a lot of things that go along with that. A lot of fun stuff. It's a show. It's a party and it's a celebration.
It is. And speaking of that, too, with all of the things that are going on, a lot of people, and I think Austinites tend to shy away from maybe coming out because they think, oh my goodness, the whole world is coming to Austin. We don't want part of it. But there are so many events that 12 and under are free, and it's a very family-friendly environment. And I'm out here a lot covering all of those events, and so I see that. I don't think Austin knows that.
Well, hopefully as they come out for other things, you know, F1 was our first event, but as you come for the concerts and you come to the amphitheater and you realize that even with the concerts, we tried to take a different approach, which is how do you make the experience, the entertainment experience, how do you make it even better? How do you make it different? So that's why you see with the amphitheater, there's that whole park area before you even come into the theater, and there's people that get there an hour and 2 hours early and play on the lawn, and you've got games out there. And then the amphitheater experience itself, it encourages you to wander around. It's not just go sit in your seat. There's great social areas, and there's the Tito's bar and things like that. And a lot of people come out and say, I had no idea this place was like this. And then X Games brings a total other dimension to it. But we have we had over 300 events out here last year. So as people discover it, hopefully they like what they experience and they come back.
Don't go away, because up next, I have an amazing beauty beat at Ray Cosmetics with fall trends in makeup.
Nothing better than a good old-fashioned Texas showdown to decide how the West was Formula One.
Nico Rosberg takes aim at teammate and defending champion Lewis Hamilton to see who is the world champion at the 2014 Formula One United States Grand Prix at the Circuit of the Americas, October 31st through November 2nd.
This is one Texas showdown you don't want to miss. Tickets available now at CircuitOfTheAmericas.com.
I am downtown for an amazing beauty beat at Rae Cosmetics with Rochelle Rae. Hi, Rochelle.
Hello.
And she is always bringing great trends, and today is about fall, right?
Fall fashion, right off the runways, super bright colors. Cobalt, fuchsia, bright purple, and we're trying to figure out how to take those bright fashion colors off the runway and put them into everyday life.
I think a lot of people are scared to get crazy and try these bold colors, like, for example, this purple, or I'm wearing this navy blue, so
absolutely.
I think people are scared.
Absolutely. They're super bright colors. When you see them, it's kind of scary and intimidating to think, I'm going to do that myself. Key is blending, and it actually makes it really easy. You can take these super bright colors, blend them, and you can wear them every day and look awesome.
Yeah,
obviously.
Because it doesn't look too bright to me. It looks beautiful. So the key, did you hear that, is blending, right?
Absolutely.
And so I think you can rock any of these colors, which of course you can get all of them at Rae Cosmetics. So come on by and try out this beauty tip. We'll be right back. Hi, I'm Holly Mills-Gardner, and I spend most of my time on this side of the lens. But when it comes to my camera, I trust the professionals at Precision Camera and Video, just like the pros. With a huge selection of cameras and accessories from entry-level to top-of-the-line pro video, all here under one roof. Conveniently located at 2438 West Anderson Lane and on the web at precision-camera.com, where the pros go.
What can you do in 31 days? How about moving to your own home? Buffington Homes has over 60 new homes ready to move into in as little as 31 days. Choose from one stories, two stories, large or small, north or south. Buffington Homes builds in the most desired communities in the Austin area, so you're sure to find one that fits your needs. Whether giving you more space for your kids or your favorite collection, having a place to barbecue outdoors or plant a garden, Buffington Homes has a solution. Find your move-in ready home today at mybuffington.com.
That's our show. Thanks for joining me. And come back every Sunday at 11:30 right here on the CW. And follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. We won't let you miss a beat. Bye.